Thank you. Sexual dysfunction. large inconsistent with the other. The recession could no longer sometimes there are certain experiences that we force ourselves to forget. I don't want to miss that. If I'm to live a normal life, then I have to try to forget.
Try to forget.
That's right. And then we think we are doing good to ourselves. But in forgetting, we are buying something which may have back. Do you think that those who love and those who care and they try to make themselves forget, let alone make okay. So which one is the first? Memories which still come back to life. But once you do an action, it will let all come back. This is what comes in when we start talking about the cognitive psychology, which explains how many of the processes involved in remembering memory are behind the scenes in the cognitive unconscious. These things affect only the memory. And we'll come back later on to remind us about the actions that we did. Why did you kill me? It comes later on, and this beautiful girl is well married, rich, and enjoying all the money, all the life, living it up to that time. And then you see somebody seeing me in all the world. Why are you seeing me? There's something wanting to happen. Or others, instead of sleeping, the day of getting over. Well, not that they are okay, but there is nothing wrong. So it is when we are in this conscious state, when by unconscious processing and guides that affect our thoughts. So personality is better explained by one's executive control, which corresponds to the individual's ability to balance edges. And now when we're talking about balancing the edges and motivation, we're trying to kind of don't remember this too much. It will affect you. Don't remember this too much. It will affect you. But this does not mean that it's not coming. In a way, it will still come back. But how do you regulate that? You have to balance. Otherwise, if you follow it, then it will affect you and you will not develop. That's how you would control some certain psychological unconscious cognitive problems when they come back, or experiences when they come back. You will have to accept it, you will have to understand it, and balance how to move now. Executive control. Which must correspond to the individual's ability to balance urges and motivations and choose the appropriate course of action. Okay. There are psychosocial stages of psychosexual stages of development, the idea of faith and death, driving behavior and the significance of dreams, that at some point may not have been supported. But it's because they, at some point, were unanswered to certain problems. They were explaining the situation. But after going on with the coming in of psychology and science, others didn't know it. Behavioral perspective. What are we looking at on behavioral perspective? In psychology. So here we're looking at psychologists like John B. Watson, who are concerned basically about studying behavior. Reacting to certain characters that people experience, that in order to detect somebody's behavior, sometimes we look at the outward and forgetting the inward, which is why we brought in the concept of introspection. So John B. Watson was influenced largely by the work of the Russian physiologist. In the life of Ivan Pavlov, all in order to determine how people behave the way they behave. So behaviorists believe that the human mind is a black box into which stimuli are sent and from which responses are received. I can choose the way you have to think by attaching you to a certain stimuli, which is going to trigger a certain kind of behavior. Are you following that? I can make you behave how I want you to behave using a certain stimulus, and you get used to it, and you think this is the way life has to be. Do you carry a student to pay when you're going to get your pay?
What?
A suit.
Lollipop.
What you carry normally? That which impresses me. Every time that when I'm going to meet you, if I carry peace, okay? Every time I'm going to visit him, if I carry Sinji, okay? You know that whenever I see him, today I'll kiss him. It is today, like I'll be satisfied. You have made me to think that when I see you visiting me, you hooked with each other. Right? Every time when we're going out, we'll go to a very expensive place. Okay? Yeah? And so, you're going to provide lunch. We're going to get a taxi. Except you taxi, not that one level taxi. You have to go and hide. Maybe what you want to talk to them. This girl feels you are to train your mind. And the next time you come, you say, so let's chat now. There's no room for again. Babe, what happened to you? Like? It's like you're going now, right? Every time she's used to, okay, or he's used to effect. I'm going out of the car, I come out and buy the car. This time it's something else, and then we just go without that. And you see somebody is waiting. What's wrong? Hey, babe! Look! What's happening? What? Yeah! You know? Don't you think you've got something? Oh, please. Okay. You give them their bed. But something must be changing. That's what will be going on in my mind. Why has he behaved like this today? Why has she behaved like this today? The teacher who always says, bye, we shall meet tomorrow, guys, okay? Yeah. Today the lecture of the class is done. Just practice the room with the course. Out. The students will not even be now, when you ask, what should we talk about?
Alison Pablo made an experiment that dogs had to salivate whenever they heard a sound.
The master used to bring food to the dog. Very delicious food.
Their mother said, "I'm going to
eat it." There was a very nice aroma of the food. And the dog was decided to eat it. Right? So whenever the bear ran, what came to the mind of the dog is food.
When the dog is disappointed,
what will happen when the bear goes and the food is not there? The dog will still expect that and will go and do it. Just by the thinking of the bear, it's actually like it. Let's go. Where is my food?
So it's possible to develop behavior
by tuning the mind. What for another behaviorist began to use these ideas to explain how events that people and other organisms experience in their environment called stimuli could produce specific behaviors called response. I am going to respond to a particular situation based on the stimuli that I give. That's why our behaviors are not likely to change, because I have got my own dreams, things that I want to achieve, right? Okay? How are we together? There are other things I want to achieve, but if they do not come now, I'll just live in a compromised state. But if they come tomorrow, you will see someone moving away. Why? The things that they wanted did not find me that time. So now that they are found me, I am ready to switch. Losing the purpose. The things I wanted, I did not get at that time. That's why I got married to you. And today, my friend, I have found somebody with money, big money. That's what I always wanted. Get out of now. It's only that that man has not come. Now that he has shown up.
Yes, I think we can part ways.
I have not found that man with the cat that seems to be wanted. Now that I have found him,
what do you think is the best? And for me to be living with you out of feet? Or
you are living with me out of feet? Try it, go now. Yeah. You can go, no problem. Why? Sometimes situations make us be what we are. Circumstances make us be what we are. So, Ivan Pavlov's research
For example, either the food or the tone would produce the response for our observation in the dog. It's either the presentation of the food or what? The tone of the bell that would trigger the salivation. So there is something that will always change the way of behavior of the person. There has to be something. What are some of the examples of things that can change the way of doing things? Nothing? Good job? Position at work. That's when you know. Poverty. That's when you know who you're very bad. When you lose money. Oh, those who are around.
Hey, it's a weekend. This weekend, yeah!
Guys, where are we drinking from? Okay. You don't even have a call. You say, guys, where are we drinking from? Because you know that your friend is going to respond. You suspect this and that because you know that your friend has got a position of influence that's going to use him. Allow him to test the quality. Once that is done, then everything is for scanning. Okay? Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Very welcome. Go and learn where. So we see the ordinary behavior can change because of something that triggers it. And we are able to detect somebody's behavior based on what may have changed them to be the way they are. Have you observed children whose parents are doing well? Or are starting to do well? If in the way of doing things change, the way of talking finally changed. Why? They also know there's something good. The food that we're eating is good. Where we're eating is good. Daddy, mommy have bought a car. No. And that changes part of your behavior somehow. A good life is always changing. A bad poor life is always changing. To behave in a certain way. So in his research, Watson found that systematically exposing a child to fearful stimuli, in the presence of objects that did not themselves elicit fear, could lead the child to respond with a fearful behavior to the presence of the stimulus. You will ask, where is this coming from? Watson also had another experiment where he had to expose the child to the rat, Camilla. Rat, Coulson. Now, every time I'm brought into this room, the rat is here, right? And so I'm playing with this rat. There's nothing that happens. Okay? This week I come and play with this rat. It runs away, it comes like, okay, I'll put it here. It climbs and like, oh, it's beautiful, right? It goes back. I'm playing with the rat. This other day, I feel you have to play with the rat. Someone who thinks it's very clever has come with a bell, right? The moment that I went to touch, to start playing with it, there's a strange tone here. Every time I try, there's a strange
God comes from. And look around, it's just the two of us, right? The more I want to touch it and play with it, the more the sound is silent. What comes to the mind is the child.
The last thing is so it brings fear to the child.
The noise of the rat will bring fear to the child. Do we agree with that?
Yes.
Now why? There is some fear that will develop in the mind of the little child because the situation has changed now. We used to play nicely, but now there's a strange something. Has my friend changed? Like, I start not to trust my friend again because every time I want to, like, he's producing now. In my mind as a kid, it's my friend who's producing the fear sound. Doesn't she want to play with me any longer? What will happen the next time when I see the rat?
Think about the sound.
The sound will come, start ringing again. And I said, I don't want you again. Right? You hear that your best friend kills somebody. And the news is all over. But the moment you just see your friend, you have that fear, right? And you already developed, I don't want to say it again. You are afraid. There's this strange feeling that has been created. So, according to Watson, an 8-month-old boy named Little Albert was used as a subject in this finding. The boy was placed in the middle of a room, a white laboratory. A white laboratory rat was placed near him and he was allowed to play with it. The child showed no fear of the rat at first, right? In later trials, the researchers made a loud sound behind Albert's back by striking a steel bar with a hammer whenever the baby touched the rat. Okay?
Sorry, this is your boyfriend you have been visiting. It's got a lot of money.
It's been all good. The next time it all just happens like as you're trying to touch him, no more romance, you hear a strange sound in the room.
Thank you.
Why does that mean?
Then your friend goes, hey, man, what's wrong?
God, no. What has triggered the fear? What has changed your mind?
The strange servant. Have they taken him away? No, it's just the servant.
Sit and listen. The child says, he was made to learn to associate with the, I mean, the white rice with the loved ones, resulting in crime. Every time I say this rice,
there is a sound noise.
And that fear in the world made him to start crying. Little outlet. And his second crime meant that we are no longer friends with the rat, right? Another most famous behavior is B.F. Skinner or Baruch Frederick Skinner. Also expanded the principles of behaviorism and also brought them to attention of the public at large. He used the ideas of stimulus and response along with the application of the word for reinforcement to train pigeons and other animals. So it is possible to train individuals or animals by using reinforcement or reward. How? When we look at the example of the dog, the bell is, there is food here. And so whenever there was the sound of the tone of the bell, the dog would tend to the food. It would go to the room where the food was on the side. And so this is why we're saying the application of the one and the reinforcement can be used to change the agreement. The story of a Tumbuka man who went to university, fought so hard, even in his old age, but so that he could just step a foot in black time. What was the reinforcement here? What was the reward here? You will only go to black time if you. So we are using education as a reinforcement for somebody to go to black. There are other people that have told their patterns to say, my friend,
I remember one of the legends abroad in Tia. He first went for preschool and then he felt like me. And then he went to the university and studied, and at a certain point said, well, I'm not. And then there was this beautiful girl who was a student. And however they crushed emotions and so this girl was on this mat. No, but don't think that life can always be bad. Not all people are bad in life. I can take care of them. And then this man told him, he said, okay, if you're reasonable, then it's okay. Concentrate on your studies. When you finish, that's what I'm married. And you have to finish with good grades. That's what I can do. You know, I'll make the and if I hear any story, that is it. After some years, we hear that the girl finished fast very well and they got married. What was the reinforcement? The reward of each was marriage, right?
Mm-hmm.
But
for that person to get married, she had to fight many of it. There was some kind of enforcement. I have to study that. The other time I want to give to our children what a reinforcement could we give? Reward. If you get number one, I'll buy a bike. Without number one, no bike. Reward. Nobody will go out for break until you answer the question. So if we have got children, we are trying to reinforce those kids who do not like participating in class. How can we use reinforcement in community development in such ways? When we are dealing with rural people, there are other people that do not want to participate in any of the activities of the rural area. How can we reinforce? Chestnut, right? From the village. Anyone who not put a garden behind their yard, they will have to be out of this village. Yeah? No? That's too harsh. It's a reinforcement for people to be responsible. Anyone who will not submit their assignment, you will not write your mid-semester exam. Anyone who not submit the assignment on time, 5 marks deducted. Ah! The reinforcement. Right? Okay. So, he used the general principles of behaviorism to develop theories about how best to teach children and how to create science that will be beautiful and productive. With ecology, you could create an environment that is beautiful and productive by training the desired behavior. Okay? The kind of desired behavior that you want. Okay? Now, would we agree that behaviorists may have contributed greatly to why people behave the way that they have? At what stage do we think it is important for behavior to start being developed? Sigmund Freud talked of the early stages of childhood. That if we do not control, she will want to marry the father. Take over the love, overtaking the love. Right? When the children are still at a very tender age, we must train them. In community, start with the children. Why? In most cases, when the tree has already grown, it is difficult to make it straight. Otherwise, in trying to make it straight, you will break it. Let's catch him and lock him in the room so that he stops drinking. Don't give beer to him. What's that good enough for you? He will just kill you. Slowly by slowly may help, but the person has already been spared. The best way was to do it when you were still young. Otherwise, at a certain point, you feel no value in telling anything to do until you face your own head. And the world changes over and changes by itself. Yeah? It's like at a certain point, we reach the point of saying, there's no value in my cross. And that's why you see most of